Okay, so first of all, thank you, AgileNCR, for giving for setting this platform to kind of talk to you guys about the minimum viable Agile. And what we look at here is design thinking in Agile. How can they rethink Agile itself? How can it rethink Agile? So before we start, we'll do a quick warm-up because I see it's a nice Friday morning, and I see some faces which are bright, already preparing for the weekend. And I see some faces which are saying that on a weekend also I have to sit in a conference and hear a few speakers out. So we'll do a quick warm-up. So I would request everyone to stand up first. Stand up, everyone. Okay, and here, everyone has to stand up. And here I give you the opportunity to get the career that you always wanted to have. So you need to divide yourself in pairs. So quickly choose your pair in 10 seconds. Choose your pair. I said a pair, not a couple, Ajay. Yeah, quickly choose your pair, guys. I just need to see you with your pairs. Okay, great. So now, decide who's person A and person B. Quickly decide who's person A and person B. Okay, so person A, you are an authority in the subject that you are. And person B, you are a press reporter. Okay, person B, you are a press reporter. And person A, whatever you say goes true. Whatever you say is the authority, is the word of the day. So person A, you have designed parachutes for elephants. Person B, you have to interview person A to know more about his design, more about his invention, and know more about him. Quickly, 30 seconds, go ahead. So some people are still deciding, you're A or B. Design thinking and Agile coming together creates a more holistic vision for the organization, for the world that we are around. Any organization, you can divide it into three parts. Imagine an organization into three spaces. There's an organization, there's a space which is the value creation space, wherein your new products, new solutions, new services, new concepts are getting evolved in an organization, the innovation that you're trying to create. The second space is the value delivery space, wherein whatever you've created, you're now delivering it seamlessly and fast to the customer, which is the value delivery space. And the third space that you talk about in any organization is value optimization. Say you've developed a product, do you need to improve it? You're also delivering it, it's a good one, it's a success, but do you still need to improve it? Yes, otherwise, a Flipkart launching an app, setting up the whole India market, with understanding that COD works well in India, COD is cash on delivery, works well in India, but Amazon, and not Flipkart not going through the upgradations, Amazon came with all its strengths and wiped out Flipkart, right? So your products will also go through the same thing. While you've invested, you've invented, you have brought that innovation out, but there are competitors who are there to copy you and commoditize it. So you have to optimize the performance of it. So if you now look at design thinking and lean startup, typically the two methods, they fit in really well in the value creation space, wherein you're trying to understand consumer challenges. Or in lean startup, you have an idea and you are conceptualizing it. You are saying that this is what I would want to do in a rough way. Value delivery is where Agile, waterfall, and all these kind of methods come in, wherein you're executing the entire solution that you're trying to say and you're delivering it to the customer. And Lean, Six Sigma, value engineering, all of this, they fit in really well in the value optimization space. So this is how, if they all come together and fire together in an organization, you create a timeless organization which is continuously innovating, continuously delivering, continuously optimizing, and the organization becomes an innovation hub. It becomes a hub which kind of is creating value for the ecosystem and the world around continuously. Okay, and that's where you elongate the life of organization as well. Before you hit the S-curve or before you hit the plateau of the S-curve, there's a new S-curve that you try to introduce every time. So two stories. The first one, Lego. We all kind of are aware of Lego as a brand. So Lego was facing a challenge of the growth stagnation, wherein the whole Lego products were facing a challenge that the S-curve was plateauing. What do we do around it? What do we do with it? So that's where they brought a element of design thinking and they started understanding what are the kids, what are the various corporate users and these kind of people, what are they aspiring and what are they using various other products or Legos for? And there was the birth of Lego Serious Play. There was the birth of various versions, which is the old cartoon Marvel and all these kind of Lego products that they have come out. That's where the birth happened. And then they have, then they do a lot of agile sprinting, which is which they call it the big room planning that they do, wherein they look at executing these products faster and bring them to the market faster. The second story, again, I've picked up stories wherein agile and design thinking have been applied in various areas of business. It is just not software development. It's been applied to various areas of business. We look at Zara. Zara was on the verge of bankruptcy. That was the situation of Zara. Okay, they had manufactured an export order, and the export or the customer had rejected that order, and they did not know what to do with the entire thing. And then bringing the fashion into the market, now Zara has created a benchmark. They have disrupted the entire fashion industry by saying that every 15 days I would have the fashion to the market. So every 15 days you visit a Zara store, you will not get the same shirt that you had seen last time, and you can just go and experience and observe it next time when you say it. Because that's a way that they're delivering business, when the whole industry is still grappling with 45 days to 90 days as a fashion time to market, and they're trying to see that how can they bring it down to the 15-day benchmark of Zara or maybe below that. And you see now both of them have become success stories, and they are where, whatever they are, they're leaders and disruptors in the market. So great, this is what I had to kind of speak in this short time. I just want to leave you with one quote before the Q&A that we do. Just because no one complains doesn't mean all parachutes are perfect. Remember, guys. So customers would not know what their challenges are. They would give you challenges which they have kind of seen or they have kind of faced. But a lot of times the challenges are deeper, and we, through empathy, need to understand those and deliver to those challenges or those needs. It's only then we'll be able to create a better, harmonious being and world around us.